It's strange. I love being a parent too. It's a weird thing learning to be a parent. It's a hard job being a parent. If not, because you sacrifice decades of your life to no sleep, no money, no social life, so your children can grow up, go on Oprah and blame every dang problem they've got on you. Aren't you getting a little tired of that? I mean, just once I want to see somebody go, you know what? My daddy was great. My mama was great. I'm just a shithead. Just one time. I know it's hard being a mom. Moms just want stuff clean. They can't even help it. I remember growing up, my mother would come into me and my brother's room about every other day. She'd go, did I raise y'all in a barn? I'd go, no. No. My brother would start laughing. She'd go, what's so funny? He'd say, nothing. Remember when your mom would say this one, shut the door, I'm not gonna heat up the neighborhood. I said, not in that bathrobe, you're not. I didn't know she could throw a waffle iron that far. Parents always say goofy stuff. Like, remember when you were growing up and they'd let you use the car and you'd stay out too late, but you thought you were so smart you could sneak back in by turning off the headlights and the ignition and coasting in that last 40 or 50 miles? Put on your camouflage jumpsuit, tiptoe down the driveway, chloroform the dog, squirt WD-40 on the door hinges, ease the key in the lock, slide it open, and there was the queen of the cold cream lagoon. Had those curlers look like horns. And my mom would always say things like, I don't want to know where you've been, what you've been doing, or who you've been doing it with. I go, thank God, Mom, because the details are a little fuzzy to me at this point. You march your fuzzy butt in here, mister. Now, where were you? I thought you said you didn't want to know. I've changed my mind, Mr. Smarty. Where were you? Well, I was in a hot tub with 10 naked women. Oh, that's so sick. I don't even want to hear about it. My dad would go, hold on, Carol. I'd like to hear a few details. Man. 10 of them, huh? That's my boy. And your parents are crazy, you know, but you made them that way. In fact, if you're grown and your parents aren't crazy, you need to ask yourself, where did I go wrong? You know, because people always told me, they said, you'll learn more from your children than they learn from you. And I'm starting to believe that. Like, I've learned this. As a parent, when you have sex, your body emits a hormone that will drift down the hall into your child's room and make them want a drink of water. And if you're extremely lucky, they will call this order in. Because there are few surprises in life to match looking your wife directly in the eye and feeling somebody tickle the bottom of your foot. It's what they call a showstopper right there. So now every night we just bathe the little girls, put them in their nightgowns and their cowbells. You learn a lot from your kids. Like just a few days ago, I learned you can get 3 boxes of raisins into the cassette player of a Jeep. I didn't know that. Last month we learned you can get goldfish out of an aquarium using a dustbuster. Y'all, I'm 36 years old. That's the most efficient fish catching device I've ever seen. Next time I go to the lake, I'm taking a Sears shop vac. Not only catch your limit, but leave the outdoors a little cleaner than you found it. Our oldest child has discovered the little silver handle on the back of the toilet. She's making more stuff disappear than David Copperfield. My wife's lost 3 combs. I lost my good sunglasses. We're pretty sure she flushed the remote control because every time we go to the bathroom, the TV comes on. Can't came home not long ago, somebody had colored on the dining room wall. My three-year-old told me the dog did it. See, that's the kind of stuff that drives you crazy. I mean, we've had that dog 8 years, and now he starts coloring on the wall. And this dog, he's a good dog, but he can't greet people and hold his bladder at the same time. Halloween night, there's not enough Scotch Guard in the world to save that rug by the front door. We're not doing well with pets. We had a hamster for almost a day. My daughter wanted to let it play with a cat. And you wouldn't think that'd be a good match. Man, that cat played with that hamster all night long. He'd play with him. We'd try to get him. He'd take him into the other end of the house, knock him up under the sofa. They were good friends. And cats, I never had cats growing up. I always thought cats were supposed to be finicky eaters. These cats we have, they'll eat anything. They can't keep most of it down, but they will eat anything. And you ever notice cats don't throw up in the daytime? They wait till you get in bed, about 2 minutes before you go to sleep, you can hear them in some part of the house going, bleh, 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 bleh. Remind me to put my slippers on in the morning, would you? I'm telling you, between youngins and animals, your whole house just goes to crap. Rule around our place is, if it ain't broke, it ain't ours. They've destroyed everything. My wife has this little statue. It used to be a ballerina. Now it just looks like the victim of a tragic farming accident. Now we have a sofa. If you sit on it in the wrong place, you can't have kids. Makes you know how your parents must have felt. Because I remember growing up, one time my brother and I were wrestling in the living room and we knocked over the ironing board and broke my daddy's Jack Daniels Elvis decanter. Should have seen mama. We just can't have nice things. See, babies today have technology. Like anybody with a baby now has a monitor. Which for those of you without kids, it's like a one-way walkie-talkie where you listen in on them. And you have to be real careful to put the right end of this thing in the right bedroom. We realized we'd made that mistake when we didn't hear our daughter cry for 5 months and her first words were, oh yeah, baby, just like that. That's really good. That's good. Of course, anybody with kids knows I'm lying now. Because when you're young and you got a choice between sleep or sex, you take sex every time. You start getting older, you got a choice between sleep or sex, you take the sleep and just hope you have a dream about sex. And I love being a parent. I guess being a parent doesn't change. Times change. I do love it, though. It's the greatest thrill of my life. Though we've officially limited that thrill to 2.